Good morning. Welcome to Fintech One podcast of BankBuddy.ai. Today we are going to talk about Composite AI implementation from practitioner's point of view. We'll delve deep into a real life use case of Composite AI, how to implement in banking industry. We have Samir. Samir, welcome to Fintech One podcast.
Thank you, sir.
Great to have you here. Please tell a little about your journey as an early adopter of AI and the progress made by the industry over the past 2 years, as you have seen, and how is AI in general impacting banking industry value chain?
So thank you, Surya, for that question. It's been a very interesting journey from very simple initial use cases of data-driven models and decision trees now to an evolved machine learning model and learning systems. There has been consistent and continuous improvement in the way AI systems have impacted the value chain. These impacts have been around from as simple as predictive models and sensitivity analysis to also chatbots, marketing support, customer service management automation, social channels based intelligent transactions processing, and also around customer onboarding and identity validation as well. Additionally, deep learning systems are also enabling decision support systems like credit decisions, risk mitigation, fraud detection analysis, etc. So overall, the journey of AI-driven systems has been a tremendous value add to the entire journey of financial institutions, and it's ever increasing.
Cool. That's pretty elaborate. Just to for the viewers to understand the context, tell us a little about yourself and your experience and how you have seen this.
So, from my perspective, I've been an avid observer of data analytics and data-driven artificial intelligence systems right from the beginning when they were decision trees leading to machine learning kind of models to current NLP, NLG, and deep learning-driven AI support systems or AI systems. So having observed that entire evolution of the space, I think it's been a very fast evolving space, mm-hmm. And it's very important to note that these systems have become almost a way of life in our common day-to-day operations, transactions from a financial services angle, or take it to our day-to-day living as individuals in society as well, whether it is as simple as social behavior or social interactions, or the products that we buy, or the e-commerce sites that we visit, or the television that we see, all the way up to the way we bank and the way we integrate with our financial services institutions as well. So that's been the journey that is very intriguing, and I do see a lot of AI systems becoming near day-to-day available to us in our daily lives.
Okay, yeah, interesting. By the way, tell us a little about your experience in terms of, you know, your career and, you know, how do you see it progressing?
Where have you seen the maximum?
Once in between, Gayatri, you know, I had a long break. You let it and...
We have a proper editing software, don't worry. So, and speak a bit louder. So, a bit louder.
Me?
Both of you.
Yeah, okay.
So we can start with this one. Can you
what
give us some examples of innovative
yeah,
products
have,
you've
yeah,
launched
yeah.
which are powered by Composite AI?
Yeah.
Now let's move to Composite AI. No?
Yeah.
No?
No?
Has the questions changed from what you had said?
The same thing.
Little some here and there, some minor changes, but it's the same thing.
Okay. This I have to just read, right, what you've written. I don't have to answer.
Okay.
Okay.
Samir, can you give us some examples of?
You started it.
Yeah.
I edited.
Okay. Samir, give some examples about innovative products what you have launched in recent past, which are powered by Composite AI.
So at our bank, what we have recently done is offered a lot of value-added propositions using Composite AI. These propositions are around eKYC of customers, multi-country WhatsApp banking, real-time account opening, liveness detection, validating customers' identity, also around a wallet product in terms of moving funds from your account into a virtual wallet and using it for transacting using social media channels like WhatsApp.
Mm-hmm.
Now these are some of the use cases that we've been able to offer to our customers. Additionally, there's a lot of engagement around customer chatbots and social media customer support services management that we also do using Composite AI platforms.
Yeah, okay. So that's pretty, you know, it's real use cases of Composite AI, because we touched upon the chatbots, which is NLP plus machine learning plus AI plus computer vision. A lot of things are there. But where do you see a maximum impact coming from?
So while AI deployment, or rather deployment of ML or AI systems, is now commonplace in our day-to-day life, and we experience it almost every other minute. Some of the maximum impact of AI-enabled systems has been in the field of direct interactions with prospective or existing customers. In more evolved and mature markets, in terms of past data availability or learning data availability, the impact is also in terms of recommendation engines, wherein the AI systems in the field of investment credit decisions or fraud checks or quant or predictive models, etc., can really help the customers, the corporate customers, and the banks themselves make some very well-informed and preemptive decisions.
Okay, and what are the key success factors which helped in implementing these solutions? What is the necessary conditions in a bank you need?
So, I would like to generalize some of the key success factors around deployment of AI systems, around three very general factors. The first one is that it is very important to understand the use case very clearly.
Right.
The impact it will make on the customers, the demographics of the customers, customer behavior towards adoption. These are very important to understand and define the use case for the AI. The second point or a success factor is it's very imperative and important to check for availability of past data for ensuring that the learning models related data points are available, such that you bring a near life predictive solution or a system to the market. And the third point is around ensuring that your entire ecosystem and your environment in which you intend to launch the AI system enables secure transactions, and also you are ready for ring fencing possible fraudulent or misuse of these systems based on, you know, as simple things as telecom infrastructure or data biases or inconsistency. So you need to pre-think these things and be ready with some kind of ring fencing processes or availability of data before you get into an AI deployment mode. So I would kind of generalize the success factors around these three things. One, understand the use case. Two, check for availability of past data points. And three, be ready for enabling and ensuring secure transactions and ring fencing operationally any possible misuse.
Okay. how important it is to engage institutional organization wide, you know, the people to understand composite AI, because this is something what a lot of people think, you know, that there's a small section of AI being used, but not as a composite AI, which is a different.
Of course, this is very important. And again, going back to my key success factors, point number one, wherein you need to understand the use case very clearly.
Yeah.
This has to be part of the entire decision process there, wherein all functions within an organization need to get together and understand what the AI use case is going to be, figure out how it would be deployed, what would be the customer demographics, and hence the involvement from the frontline business teams, the operational teams, the IT teams,
the compliance
teams, etc., is very important for defining the use case.
Yeah. Okay. If you have to do a little bit of crystal gazing, where would you place the AI importance levels across organizations, especially, you know, relevant to us in the financial industry?
So from a financial industry perspective and taking a look at how AI relevance is going to increase, I would like to kind of respond by stating that all AI systems, and specifically in the financial industry system, are rapidly getting classified into three categories of solution or a combination thereof. The first is solutions which enable customer interaction and experience management. Now these could be AI systems around onboarding, around customer service management, interactions, chatbots, etc. The second is data-driven decision support systems. So this is the second field or categorization wherein recommendation engines, fraud detection, compliance monitoring, everything which is inherent to a financial institution and run in the background basis, a lot of data churning and analytics can become a decision support system driven AI solution.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, the third one is around internal process automation and combining with robotics process automation tools. And this is essential to deliver a very consistent, real-time, and almost always available customer needs fulfillment solutioning. So all AI systems are rapidly getting classified into these three categories. And to reiterate, the first category is customer interaction and experience automation. The second one is data-driven decision support systems enablement. And the third one is automating the internal processes and combining with RPA to deliver 24/7 error-free or almost near zero errors kind of solutions.
Okay. One last question, just continuing on this. So where would you see, beyond looking at the financial institution or a bank, at a macro level, at a country level or a regional level, AI getting impacted, not taking little, stepping a little out of the financial services industry like a bank? Is it going to shape?
So right from, let's say, about a couple, let's say about a few years back, from a decade to 15 years kind of a perspective to where we are now,
mm-hmm.
AI is near commonplace in our day-to-day, whether you are using an Apple phone and talking to Siri or a Google Assistant on an Android phone or on Netflix trying to see your next
recommended movie
or an Amazon bookstore where your next book or your next purchase is being recommended, AI has become pretty commonplace. And if you notice, again, the categorization is very similar to my previous points around how AI is getting categorized in the financial services, which is one is all about customer interaction and experience part of it in our day-to-day life, whether it is e-commerce or whether it is healthcare or whether it is financial. Second is, again, enabling individuals or corporates to take their decisions. So it's recommendation engine, for example, and also enabling a lot of process automation. So for example, if you had to step up and make a payment at a physical bank counter to actually now changing it to the systems reminding you that this payment is due, and then you could use your SI or your app to actually make the payment, those kind of systems. It's all as an underlying layer in where and what we do. So AI systems are available there, and they are enabling our day-to-day life. There was one more question that you didn't ask.
The last one. I thought we want to skip that, right?
I think what is missing is a practitioner's approach.
Yeah.
There was one thing which was a question: if why did you choose to go with a composite AI product?
We didn't talk about it, right? That is the biggest piece. Now, see, the whole thing is about practitioner's approach to composite AI. That is the most critical piece. So you can ask that now.
So this question, why did you choose to go with a composite AI product?
Touched upon it. Okay.
I had a very nice answer for that.
Okay. Okay. So maybe I'll just introduce you one line about, you know, give you a background, then maybe. Samir, one more question. Why did you choose to go with the composite AI product route?
It is not about choosing a composite AI product or a solution. The key there is delivering value to the customer journey and simplifying it.
Mm-hmm.
Both from a customer experience and from an internal process optimization perspective. It has to be end to end. And hence the use of an underlying AI platform offering computer vision capabilities for liveness checks or identity authentication, combining it with an NLP, NLG based interactive session for the customer, and deep learning models based transaction need recognition, fulfillment. These are all key to digitalizing the customer experience. And this end-to-end digitalizing of the customer journey comes, if it comes on the basis of a composite AI product, then so be it, because that is the key objective.
It's like you're pushing that.
No.
So be it.
Yeah.
What the fuck, you know? There's no choice.
Let me answer that in a different manner.
Yeah.
This is what I said, you know.
It's not use case driven, it is the technology driven. Not one component is going to fulfill your.
Okay,
you know.
And we talk about that, you know, in banking industry, we've always had silos and all that. So
sure.
Instead of having those silos, now we said, at least at this level, we build a common layer of intelligence, which has
multiple technologies. Yeah.
Let me repeat the answer.
Yeah.
So it's not about choosing a composite AI platform, but the key is delivering value to the customer journey and simplifying it, both from a customer experience and from an internal process optimization perspective. And hence the use of an underlying composite AI platform which offers computer vision capabilities for liveness checks, identity authentication, and NLP, NLG based interactive sessions, and deep learning models based transaction need recognition and fulfillment. These are all key to digitalizing the customer experience. And hence, if you have one platform which offers these composite AI capabilities with a common data, underlying data layer, it just enables the companies and the users and banks like us to actually deliver the customer value and the customer digitalized experience in a much better, seamless manner.
Okay, so you're not talking about a silo kind of a solutions, which will say, okay, there's a chatbot which will use a different NLP engine, there's a recommendation engine which uses a different set of an AI, computer vision is a different piece, but you're looking at everything to be a mesh kind of a solution?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And that's the key, because if you have siloed solutions, every solution will have its own underlying data layer, will have its own logical algorithms working on it, and this could create possibly an inconsistency in the customer experience. And to just avoid this inconsistent layer is where a common platform with a composite AI really comes in handy and avoids the silo issue as well.
Okay. Inclusion.
Blockchain, Web3.
Yeah, okay.
That I was
okay, I'll skip blockchain, I'll skip Web3. We'll talk about, let's see, what is the new technology.
Right? Kind of
no, not risk
like, you know, very opinionated kind of,
what's the problem?
It's okay. Well, you are supposed to have opinion, right?
Blockchain.
Per capita opinion, India is still leading. Okay. So, Samir, so apart from Composite AI, what else, what other technologies or trends you foresee in near future, like blockchains, CDBCs, those kind of things? Any thoughts?
It's not CDBC, it's CBDC.
CBDC. It's a CDBC. Okay.
Repeat.
Okay. Okay. Samir, so this Composite AI is a very valid point. What do you see, unfolding in near future? Things like blockchain, CBDCs. Any of these things excites you?
Oh, well, yes. As a follower of emerging technology and as a tech evangelist, these are fantastic times to be living in. The amount of tech-driven enablement which is available and the amount of technology solutions which you can really learn and imbibe in your day-to-day life are phenomenal. Now, if these are around blockchain technologies wherein the use cases are increasing by the day, whether it is in automating tokenizations based authentication or whether it is tokenized based transactions, those are the blockchain capabilities which we are seeing in our use cases on a day-to-day basis. Whether we move on to AI systems, which we've spoken about becoming an underlying layer in our day-to-day life and operations. Again, CBDCs or digital currencies based around the blockchain are another fantastic use case which will just bring a different level of payment authentication and the agile mode in which payments can actually be transacted in a very secure and trusted manner. These are all enhancements which are already available or just around the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from this, there are various other technologies based around, learning systems, artificial intelligence, etc. Simple cases like driverless cars, your automated straight-through processing of various types of transactions, security-related parameters and AI-driven cybersecurity tools, which are more based on pattern recognition and blocking rather than the traditional old methodologies of perimeter security and active monitoring using security operation centers, etc. So there are various enablers coming from an enhanced data availability, data analytics availability, leading to solutions like AI systems, robotics, augmented reality, virtual reality solutions. And these are technologies and solutions which will really change the way we live our lives, if not already. And the day-to-day impact is tremendous. So, these are fantastic times to live in. The use of technology in our day-to-day life, whether it's in our social behavior, whether it is in the way our demographics are evolving, all that is amazing and it is quite and the way it is evolving is quite impactful and making a change in our day-to-day lives.
What about metaverse? Would you see yourself buying an NFT in near future?
Well, Web 3.0 concept, metaverse, these are all exciting as well.
Yeah.
recently was playing a game on augmented reality using the, you know, the entire
Oculus
mm-hmm. from Meta.
Yeah.
And just the entire experience of gaming was so different. And while it is still a bit crude,
hmm.
the
yeah,
evolution in that
is yes.
fantastic.
Yeah.
And the speed at which it is evolving is also
yeah.
fantastic. So recently there was a news about a very famous digital bank engaging with Meta in terms of beginning to experiment with how banking can be done in the metaverse.
Yeah.
And you know, these are the kind of actions which give a shot in the arm to these emerging technologies and the way we behave. And from that perspective, I'm very excited about what metaverse and Web 3.0 will bring to the table and bring to our experience in our day-to-day lives. But any technology is as good as its utilization
and
adoption.
And use cases, sir.
And use cases, exactly. So that remains to be seen, but the underlying technology is very
yeah.
exciting.
The future is
the
promising.
The future, yeah.
Future
yeah.
is promising, and the future is now.
Future is now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Samir. That's wonderful.